Hi everybody, welcome to another how-to video with Salome Mecca and Codaster. And today I want to expand on the last tutorial that Lorenzo did on Calc Ferraglias, on the calculation for reinforcement, and talk a little bit more about this and show some hacks, how we can interpret the results better in ParaView and let's say expand a little bit on this argument. So I'm going to start from the same example that he used. It was a simple slab, 5 meters by 2 meters. You can see it here. This is the mess. And the first thing that I want to show is that if we go to the mesh module, and we activate the mesh, we right click and we select orientation of faces, we can see the normal direction of these faces. In this case, the normal direction is in the positive z direction, and this is important because this tells us what is the superior and what is the inferior reinforcement. The other thing that I want to do is to change some of the boundary conditions and the loads. So I'm going to have in the supports to restrain also the rotation along the x-axis. It will not be a simple supported beam anymore, and this because I want to see also what is the reinforcement in the supports when you have fixed ends. More realistic in general, and we see, let's say, the difference. And then for the load, okay, this is okay. For the load, I'm going to apply a higher load. We were using 2 kilopascal. That was the total load. If we do some calculations, say that we can arrive at 15 kilopascal or maybe something less, let's say 12 kilopascal. So I'm going to say 12,000. Okay. And let's see a little bit about the element. The element was 0.3. I want to reduce this a little bit. Let's say that we have 22 centimeters of a slab. And the vector that is the normal, the x-axis, the local x-axis is along the y-direction. This is also important when we see the reinforcement. Then I'm going to go in the calculation of the reinforcement, Calc Ferraglias, and I just want to add a value here that is the density of steel, and we are in kilograms. So 7,800, because this can give us also the density of steel with respect to the volumetric density of steel in the plate. And with all this, we are good to go. Let's do the calculation. This we can delete. Not take time, should be ready. Okay, green. So let's go and see the results. And we are in the desktop tutorial. Okay. Let's check first the deform shape. We are sure that we have the correct deform shape. We want the 3D. And this is exactly what we expected. I'm going to work this. And let's see the reinforcement. So we are in the X direction, which is the main direction of the slab, and we are in the inferior part. Now we see that in the inferior part we have the reinforcement, let's say in the middle section slab as expected, while in the supports is close to zero. If instead we look at the superior, we see the opposite expected again. So we can see, let's say, the difference, and the shear is again lower in the middle and increasing the supports. Then we can see the volumetric density of steel, and here we see exactly that it is there is a minimum, let's say, but then it is increasing in both the middle the supports, and this would should be density with respect to the volume of the slab. And last but not least, we have this constructability ratio. So this is an indicator that goes from 0 to 1 and tells you the difficulty to accommodate this reinforcement in this plate. So in this case, it's pretty low, let's say, so there should not be any problems. We can see that as we go in the supports, it will be more, let's say, more difficult to accommodate it, but still we shouldn't have any problems. Now, what I want to show is how we can interpret the results. Let's say that we are here and we have this number that is the area in square meters of reinforcement per meter. So for all these four fields, we have a value per meter when the shear reinforcement is area per square meter. And I want to show here something. Let's say that we have this value, and we can use this calculation tool, and we can go to the cell data, which will give us the scalar value. So let's go to the inferior reinforcement, and if I divide by the area of a reinforcement bar that I want to consider, I will obtain the number of bars this specific reinforcement. So if I have this table, very simple table, let's say that I use P12, so I have 113 millimeters square. So since we are in meters, I have to use 113 the minus 6. And this gives us this calculation. We have 1.6 bars per meter in this case. If we use the superior, you can see that I have more or less, we have 3 bars in the support and diminishing. And we can also go back or something else. So we had 1.6, but let's say that we want a value that is an integer, so we can use some of the functions that we can see here, and I can say ceiling, so it will round the upper value. So this will give me 2, and the superior. For the superior reinforcement, in this case value of 4, but it was close to 3. Let's also use the DNST. Let's say that we want to use 79. So again, this will give you how many, say, P10 per square meter you have to use. So this is all I wanted to show with this quick video. I hope it was interesting for you, and see you next time. Bye.